Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama, and I thought I'd take this time to do a little demonstration of some of the jewelry that I've created. I've just created these pieces for the last show that I did, and of course, these are my carryovers. So I thought I'd do a little demonstration for you to show you how these earrings look on me, and I'm using myself as a model. I am not the best model, people, but you know, I have a difficult time tracking people down to, you know, be still enough to model for me. So I decided that I'll do my own personal demonstration for you of my jewelry, the way I would wear it, how I look in them. So I decided to do a demonstration of my latest pieces that I've done, and I hope that you enjoy them. So just sit back and relax, and I'm gonna do a video of them too, so that you'll get a chance to see them without me. Okay. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist, and I hope you enjoy the show. Okay, peace. Okay, now I don't even know where I left off at or anything, but I was showing you these blue earrings. So I'm gonna put them back in again, in the event you didn't get to see them. Now that's the price on the back, so I'm gonna turn that around. You have to go to the site to see how much they cost. But anyway, that's how they fit, like that. Okay, these are my blue onyx. Then I have some purple onyx with the black butterfly in the middle. These are the purple onyx with the black butterfly. I really like those. I really like these myself. You know, I made me a pair of these. I like these purple onyx. Because I love big earrings. I don't know about y'all. But I like big earrings, you know. Even though there is some kind of social stigma about women who wear big earrings, I really don't give a damn about what people think. You know, I wear what I like, and I like big earrings. And these. Okay, these are some blue, I call these bows. I don't know what you would call them, but I call them bows. These are some blue earrings that I made. They're kind of big too. I think these might be about 4 or 5 inches. I'm not sure, but I think I think they're about 4 inches. Let me see. Yeah, they're about 4 inches, but I really like them. I think they're cute. They're light too. They're not heavy. I think they're cute, particularly if a sister got a long, you know, one of those nice long slender necks. I think these would just look so cute on her. Okay. Then I created these. These are some leather onyx with studs around them. And I'm going to try these on for you just so you can see how these look. Of course, oops. Boy, today is not a good day for trying on stuff. And I think trying to do things on your lunch hour is, but my lighting at home, I tried to do this at home. My light at home is not good. So I think I'm gonna have to get some brighter bulbs. But anyway, that's how these look, like that. These are leather, leather on the back, leather on the front with the onk on the front. And if you can see, the onk has hieroglyphs on it. So you can see the hieroglyphs on the onyx. I also have another pair of onyx earrings that I would like to demo for you. And these have these really cute hooks. I think these are so cute. I like these hooks. They're leverbacks. And I have really thin earlobes. I mean, I got the thinnest earlobes on the planet. I wish I had nice thick earlobes, but I don't. I have thin earlobes. So, okay, and that's these right here. Can you see them? These earrings, that's how they hang like that. Just thought I'd do my own personal demo of my own doggone jewelry, just so y'all can see. Because I definitely wear my own stuff, okay? And then I made these earrings here. Now, I think some bold sister attempt to wear these right here. These are my wooden earrings, but they got a leather Africa in there. And then I got these little colorful I forgot what they call these. These are, I can't think of the name of them. But anyway, I put these little colorful things all around them. But anyway, let me put them on so you can see what they look like. And they're really super light. I mean, these are super light, okay? But they're made of a really light wood. So, pull my hair back so you can see. See, that's how these look. This is how they look on. And they're not really that long on my little neck, on my little short neck. They don't even like, but I've had some, my swirly girls, they touch my shoulders. They are really irritating. I have to take those off when I get in my car. Cause you know, you're trying to drive, you got the big ass earrings on, you're trying to drive. But these here, I think I could rock these. I definitely could rock these for real. Cause they're not heavy at all. So yeah. Yeah, those are good. Let me see. Y'all see that gray hair right there? Watch that. There it go. It's gone. See, I put that sucker out, man. You get my age, you have gray hairs growing everywhere. You look up and there's a gray hair. I eject that sucker out. No problemo. Now, these are an Adinkra symbol. There is an Adinkra symbol that's a comb. And these are made out of patent leather. Okay, see, that's why they're kind of shiny. And then I put the studs around them, which I think added a little something to them. So I'm going to try these on for you. Even though I think I could have probably did a better job on these. They were kind of difficult to cut out. I'm going to try to redo them. Redo them because I have some more of this. But anyway, I made these in blue. Boy, that sister snatched those blue ones up so fast. They were just like these, but they were blue leather. And they wasn't patent leather. They were just regular leather. That sister snapped those up so quick last Sunday. But that's how these hang, which I really, really like. I think I might try to make maybe some black ones. I might try to make some red ones. I really like these. I like these, especially with this hook. Now, I don't know how they'll go with all the hooks will go with the other colors, but I will give that a shot. Now, I have these hoops that I made. You know, them big round earrings. Some of y'all like these. They're not particularly my favorites, but I was asked to make some like this, so I did. But they're not particularly my favorites. I mean, I'm not a ball hoop type because I see too many people with these on. So I generally don't wear, you know, a lot of earrings that I see a lot of people wear. I don't, you know, like follow the trends. But anyway, but I made some because someone asked me to see if I could make them. So I tried, you know, to make some with my own wire and stuff. And that's how they turned out with my own beads. I made these beads myself. So I guess they look okay. I don't know. What do you guys think? I don't know, but I'm going to put them up there for sale. If you want to buy them, they are definitely available to you. Okay, now that I've shown you the latest earrings that I made, I really, really want to show you something I'm really proud of. I really like these pendants, these necklaces that I made out of leather, and I am just so excited about them that I can't wait to show them to you. Okay, boy, they are kind of like not really tangled, but I really like these necklaces. I think they are absolute. They are so cute. Okay, I'm going to start with, this is a blue one. Let me see how I am in the camera so you can see. This is a blue one. This is made of leather. And you see I got the butterfly on there. This is a leather cord. I'm just going to try it on for you so you can see how it looks on me. How it hangs. Oops. Turn it straight. Okay. It fits like that. I like these necklaces. I think they are so cute. And of course, you know, you can always, if you're smart, you can adjust your stuff in the back to make it, you know, shorter or as long. But I think that they are about 18 inches long, you know, normally. Normally, I think they're 18 inches long. I think this is about 18 inches. But this is leather. I really like those, these necklaces. And I would say they're probably about an inch by an inch or something like that. But anyway, here's another one. This is red. This is a red one. I'm gonna try this red one on for you. This is a red one. See, they're really easy to put on. And I gotta see how they look myself. And that's how it looks. And this is leather. So these, I'm just gonna show you, you know, like, I'm not gonna try them all on, but that's basically how they hang like that. And here's one in yellow with the black butterfly. I just wanna see if you could see this because I can't see if you see it. But anyway, that's a back black butterfly. I'm gonna do a video show, you know, a slideshow with these so you'll get a chance to see them up close. Here's another one. It's kind of beige with a beige butterfly on a white leather cord. These I did to be unisex for men or women. And on the back is a gold, you know, gold, and on the front is black. This is leather, hand painted. Here's another one with a Sankofa bird. It's got the Sankofa bird. Really don't like the yellow one on the back, but the blue one on the front is pretty cool. I like that one. And it's on a gold cord, golden cord. Here's another one with King Tut on there with a red cord. It's King Tut. You know, if a guy wanted a long one, I can make it longer, but I don't know if a guy would wear this. I'm not sure, you know. Here's the war horn. It's an Adinka symbol. It's a war horn. Here is another Adinka symbol that I made on the front and the back. And that's it for those. Now, oh, I forgot. I have more. Okay, these, man, I really like these, especially the clasp. I like those. This is another leather necklace. I want to try this one on. I like this one. I think these are kind of dressy. I like these. This is another one. Where's my mirror? This is another one. I like these. I like this. I like that necklace. It's really nice. I like it. Anyway, I don't want to get lost in my own stuff. But anyway, that one is kind of beige, and I got a little decorative ornament there on there. There that one is. And then I have one with a beautiful flower on it. And this cord is not a leather cord. I think they call these not bungee cords, but this is a certain type of a cord. I can't think of the name of it, but it kind of feels rubbery. But anyway, that's that one. Cute, that's the back of it. Here's another one that I made. And this one has a design and a gem on it that I created. That's the back of it. All of these are leather. Here's a yellow one. Get the yellow one out because I don't have a lot of time. That's the yellow one. That's yellow. And here's the back. That's the front of the piece. And let me see. Do I have another? Oh, yeah. Here, I have another one. This one I really like, too. I think this is a nice piece. It's the back of the piece. It's the front of the piece. So that's for those. Those are my leather necklaces. I guess I don't know what you would call it. You call them necklaces. Those are necklaces that will be up on my site soon. And now I'm going to show you my Kumihumo Goddess Rising necklaces. These are basically chokers. Like chokers, and this is like my favorite symbol, so you'll probably see a lot of these, but that's how the Kumihumo fits, like that. That's how it fits, you know, for especially y'all who got them pretty necks. You know, I'm old, I got an old neck, so I'm demonstrating on my old neck, but that's okay. I don't have no nice soft neck to do it on. I have to do it on my own neck. But that's one of them. And here is the Kumihumo in a round Kumihumo necklace. And this is a clasp to that. They go on really easy. Try that on for you. And there it is. Laying like that. That's how that's laying like that. Got the goddess rising on there. The goddess is always rising with her little gem. Yes, indeed. I just thought I'd take this time to show you a few of my pieces. I also wanted to show this one. Because I think I've shown this on my site before, but I don't think people really know how it really fits. And that's this piece right here. And I'm going to, excuse me, I'm going to try it on, demonstrate it for you. Okay. It fits like this. How you like that? And that Kyrie shell is right there in the middle. Pay no attention to the rough neck here, the old neck. Don't pay attention to the neck, okay? Because it's 60 years old, all right? But just look at the necklace. But that's how the necklace fits, like that. That's how it fits. It's pretty nice. And I like the little Kyrie shell in the middle. I like that Kyrie shell. It's just clashing with this. I bet you if I had black on, it'll probably look a whole lot different. But these colors are clashing to me. I can't take it. I gotta take it off. It just looks horrible. I don't like those colors clashing like that. And then I have, of course, my goddess rising in the, I don't know what color you would call this. It's a olive kind of color, Kumihumo. And you just hook it in there in a chain. And there it is. It's kind of adjustable. The size, I think I got it on upside down. This is supposed to be at the bottom, not at the top. That's why it looks like that. Because I have it on wrong. Okay, there you go. That's how it's supposed to go. I had it on wrong. Okay, then we'll get a true vision of how it looks. Okay, and there it is. Oh God, I got it on backwards. I got it on backwards. Jesus Christ. Why can't I get it right, guys? I think it's because I'm in a hurry. You know, it's like just a lunch hour. I don't have like a lot of time. Okay, there it is. There it is. This is how it goes. All right. God, finally. Gotta take your time and get it right. There it is. That's how that fits. Now that color doesn't look that good on my skin, which is why I don't wear the olive a lot. But this is not a good color for my skin color, you know, I don't think. Anyway, but that's how that fits. That's my Kumihumo Goddess Rising necklaces. You know, get the wrinkles out my neck so you can see. Move the wrinkles out the way so you can see, okay? That's that old neck, man. You get old, trust me, every one of y'all go have it. I don't give a damn what you do now. All right? And here's another Kumihumo necklace. It's got the round instead of the flat cord. And of course, I weave these myself. Most of the things I do, as a matter of fact, all the things I do myself. You know, I don't buy ready-made cords. I, you know, braid them myself. I've learned the method and I use them. This is another Goddess Rising necklace, if you can see that. Okay. And then last but not least, I have another one here in black. This is a black one, and of course they got a Kyrie shell on the back. I forgot to show you guys that. And they have a chain. So they're kind of adjustable. You know, they're adjustable to a skinnier neck, but not much for a bigger neck. So if you got a bigger neck than mine, let me know and I can put a bigger chain, longer chain on it for you. But that's how the black one looks, okay? And of course, she has like red, black, and green gemstones, and then one at her tail, okay? That's how those look. So anyway, that is the demo that I wanted to do for you guys for my jewelry. And of course, I will be putting up a slideshow so that you can get a better look at them. You know, because you could probably see them better in a slideshow than around my neck. But I just wanted to, you know, kind of like demonstrate to you how I wear them, how I would wear them. And the intent when I created them, how I wanted them to fall, you know. And so that's it for my little slide, my little demonstration of my jewelry. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I enjoyed doing it. And they will be up on my site shortly. You know, it takes a minute for me to get it up there because, you know, you got to fix the pictures and you have to size them down. And sometimes I have to tweak them, you know, with color or lighting or something like that. But what you got right now is exactly how they look, okay? So I just wanted to share with you today some of my pieces. And these are the ones that I'm really, really proud of. I really like these. I think they are just really nice necklaces. I just think these are nice necklaces that are made of leather. They're very well crafted. And, you know, I just hope that you guys like them as well. And they're not that expensive. I mean, you know, I don't charge a lot for my pieces. I don't think they're expensive. You know, not me. And these are the smaller ones. They are even less expensive than these are. So these are less expensive than those. So these are my necklaces. And like I said, you know, these are like my favorites because these are like the newest addition to my collection is these necklaces right here. So these are like the latest things that I've made along with the earrings that I showed you. Those are like the latest pieces that I've done. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama of Earth and Ocean Jewelry Designs. I hope you know, enjoyed the little mini show that I gave you. And I hope that you go to my site at www.earthandoceanjewelrydesigns. Oh yeah, and let me show you something else too. I forgot about that. With that necklace, you can buy either earrings that look like this. And you know, they've been all in the bag, so some of them are all a little messed up. But you know, these earrings right here go with this necklace. I created them to go with that. I got two, as a matter of fact, I got two different kinds. I got some like this, and then I have those that look like this. I don't know how that came off because I couldn't see the mirror. But just to put that on record, these go with this. I made those to go together, but I will sell them separate. But you know, because some of you, you know, you don't like sets. Sets used to be the shit back in the day. Used to have your earrings matching. You know, your earrings matching, your necklace. Let me see how that look. Yeah, you have to straighten those out. But that's how those used to look, you know, back in the day. Back in the day, we used to be matching, man, I swear. Today, it's not so much like that. I mean, people just wear all kind of different stuff. And that's why they was all kind of smushed up, because I have them in this little bag, all of them together. But anyway, that's it for my little demonstration. I hope that you liked it. I hope that you will also come by my shop. Check it out. I have more things on the burner to be put up. And show me some love, man. I'm gonna have to put me a guest book up on this, on my site, because this new site doesn't have a guest book. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to get my new host. I don't have a guest book up, so I'm gonna have to figure out how to put up a guest book so that you can come and sign in and tell me what you think about my jewelry or something to that nature. Don't say nothing bad, because I might send you back something you might not like. Because this is my art. Just want to put that on record. This is my art. And as an artist, honey, you know how we are. We're funny about our art. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I'm done with this demonstration. I hope that you enjoyed it. And I will be putting up a a slideshow, a video of my jewelry, probably add a little music to it or whatever, make it entertaining for you. I forgot to show you these earrings. These are some earrings that I have too. These are leather too, made out of leather too. They were all on display Sunday, last Sunday at the show that I did, but they're not, they didn't go, you know, but I sold enough, that's for sure. Some of the things I sold, in case I don't have them anymore. But anyway, with that said, thank you everybody for taking the time out of your day to, you know, share this with me. And I hope that I see you, you know, purchasing something. I hope you find something that you like. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Peace, everybody.